Welcome and good morning to Mike Ferry TV. It is the week of June 3rd, and we hope that you have been studying, looking at, practicing your listening presentation. What we're going to do today, and we're actually now well into this Mike Ferry Sales System series, is look at the heart and soul of what makes a great agent, and that, of course, is the listing process. We're going to go through it step by step today. I want you to review this particular program every day this week. If you can watch it 5, 6, 7, 8 times before we have our next program next week, you're much better off. The more you review this, the better chance you have of understanding it. We'll start by this. I created this listing process virtually back in the early 1970s. I created it because I had gone to some training seminars for our industry on listing property. And quite honestly, here I was, a new licensee back early 1970s. I watched professional people present how to present. And quite honestly, it just didn't seem to make any sense to me. Now, I'm not saying that I was smarter than they were. I'm not saying that I'm better than they were. They were presenting what they thought was best for us to know. But sitting in the audience as a professional salesperson with a sales background coming into real estate, it just simply didn't make sense. You know, go into the house and build rapport. Tell them how much you like their home and tell them how much you enjoy being with them and tell them how beautiful their home is. You know, that just didn't make sense. Because my thought was, we're invited to the house with a business proposition of doing something to help them get their home sold. And we were straying so far away from that and everything that's being taught. And of course, I said this to you in the past and I'll say it again. The reason why people spend so much time building rapport is because they don't know what to say when they're talking to that particular prospect. Building rapport is an excuse for not knowing how to sell. So I sat down and I said to myself, okay, what should we say on a listing presentation? You know, what should be said? And I came up with three questions that I want you to consider. And the three questions are the questions a seller asks in their mind and many times asks the agent direct. Obviously, question number one, how much is my house worth? And most of the training is never going to get to the point of telling them what it's worth. Ours does. Question number two, how long will it take to sell? And we don't want to hear that question as an agent because we're afraid to commit because we don't know how to price it in the first place. And question number three, what are you going to do to get it sold? Well, these three questions are obviously critical to a seller. And if you really analyze, every seller wants these three questions answered. So my question then for you is, why do we spend so much time talking about everything else but those three questions? Then I looked at a second phase and I said, okay, what other questions does a seller want answered on a presentation besides the obvious three? And I started making a list of those questions and I thought to myself, if I walk into a house and I say to a seller, I know there are four or five questions that need to be answered, would you mind if I answer them for you right now? The seller's going to say yes. This is very logical, very sales-oriented, obviously not real estate-oriented. Sales-oriented. We're salespeople. They're hiring a salesperson. They're paying us a sales commission for our sales skills. So I said, you know what? If I can walk into a house and I can answer the questions they have, then I can say, are there any other questions? And if they say no, would you like me to handle the sale for you? If they said yes, sign the contract. Then I went a step further. And I said, okay, at the end of me answering their questions, there's a pretty good chance some of them could give me some objections. So I made a list of the objections that a seller would give. Again, very logical. I say this, they say that. I say these five things, they respond with this. What are they going to respond with? What objections will they have? Are they going to say to me, I have a friend in the business, I want to compare companies, I want a higher price, I want you to cut your commission. Are they going to say these things? And the answer is yes. So I thought to myself, the stronger I can answer their questions, the less apt they are to give me objections. Now, some of the training that I had in the early days was, and you could appreciate this, is still being taught today, pathetically. Watch this. A seller won't list with an agent unless the agent receives lots of objections. My belief is, if you're good at your presentation, you should never get an objection. They'll want to sign a contract. So we have two totally different mindsets, remember 2 weeks ago, two different belief systems on how we make a listing. See, my attitude is this. Everybody says walk into the house and build rapport. So what does that mean? How are you and how's the kids? And oh, I see you have a cat. Who gives a crap whether they have a cat? I'm there to list their home for sale and get their home sold. Oh, I see you play golf. You have a golf trophy. The guy says, no, I bought that at a swap meet. I mean, what? That's stupid to say those kind of things. But if we walk into the house and say, there are three questions I need to ask to start. Question number one, I talked to you 2 days ago. You said you had to sell your home. Do you still have to sell your home? And they say yes. Question number two, do you want to price it to sell or keep it on the market a long time? Well, we didn't like the price you sent us in the pre-listing package. I understand we need to decide on a price, don't we? Yes, we do. But you want to get it sold, right? Yes, I do. And then question number three, do you want me to handle the sale for you? See, there has to be a beginning to the presentation. And the beginning is not telling them how beautiful their home is, because what if the house is not beautiful? What do you say then? How did you make the house look like this? You can't say that. So therefore, we have to think about what we are doing. So what I did is I put together a 5-step listing process for myself to follow. I trained a lot of the agents that I worked with in the same office how to use it. I've been training agents with this listing process since 1975. Now, I know this will bother some of you, but the majority of all the best agents in North America follow this listing process, and even better yet, every competitor I have has stolen the process and uses it and teaches it as if it's their own. I know where it came from. I gave birth to it. This is my baby. Listen to the originator. Don't go to the copy, go to the original. Here's the process. Watch this. Step one, pre-qualify 100% of the people, 100% of the time, no exceptions, using 100% of the questions we offer. I've asked you several weeks ago to download the pre-qualifying questions. There's 12 to 15 questions depending on how they respond. I am never gonna go on a listing presentation until they are pre-qualified 100%. Here's what I wrote down. It determines if they're serious or not. It gives you their concerns and their objections. It demonstrates your professionalism, and it gets you around the building rapport stage by getting to their motivation. That's what pre-qualifying does. So step one in the listing process is pre-qualify every seller every time. But Mike, what if it's the next door neighbor? So why would you treat them differently? A doctor in the emergency ward doesn't treat the next door neighbor differently. Oh, it's my next door neighbor. Let's not hurt him. Don't give him a shot. We don't want them to feel bad. The doctor's gonna follow the procedure no matter what the circumstances are. If it's your next door neighbor, guess what? Make sure you go ahead and follow the procedure. Pre-qualify 100%. Step two, mail or deliver a pre-listing package. I've been talking about this for years and I can't get most agents to follow it. It has to be a non-ego-based pre-listing. They don't want to see 27 pictures of you in your pre-listing package, especially when you use your high school picture. They don't want to see a picture of you and your dog. I mean, this is a professional business we're involved in. In the pre-listing package, obviously, a couple of personal references that they can call. They never do. Please call any of these people to check on whether my service is valid or not. Obviously, a copy of your marketing or plan of action. Obviously, if you want to put your company track record or your company's track record, here's the number of transactions we have done in the last 60 days. Great. Obviously, a completed CMA with a suggested price. Oh, Mike, I don't know if I like that one. It doesn't matter whether you like it. That's the procedure we follow if we're going to list property. A completed net sheet breaking down the costs. A completed contract with a check mark for them to sign the contract, and any disclosure statements that you choose to use, because everybody uses different disclosure statements. Now watch this. This package simply is going to be delivered or mailed to them 24 to 48 hours in advance. What it does is it sets up them for your coming in. It answers most of their questions, but more importantly, are they always going to like what they see, for example, on price? No. So now you'll see when I get to step three in the listing process, which is call back and confirm and make sure that they've received the package and read it. So I called Mrs. Smith back. Hi, Mrs. Smith, it's Mike. Did you receive the package that I sent? Well, yes, we did, and we're very upset. Oh, I'm sorry to hear that. What part of the package upset you? Now, I already know what upset them. It's the price and the commission. Well, quite honestly, we were very concerned about that price you put in the package. Okay, I understand. We told you when we talked to you we needed $400,000. I do remember that very clearly. And in this package, you said it's going to sell for $350,000. Well, did you read the comp sheet I put in? That's the actual sales that have taken place. But we have to have $400,000. Mrs. Smith, you know what? The moment I walk in the door, let's you and I and your husband address the issue of price. And let's get that taken care of. Fair enough? Okay, fine. See what this pre-listing package did along with the recall? It drew out the final objection in advance. I can now prepare as a professional knowing that my problem is going to be price. I call back and confirm. Mrs. Smith, did you have a chance to read the package? Yes, we did, and we're very upset. Oh gosh, what are you upset about? Well, first of all, you put down a 6% commission. Mrs. Smith, I can go higher. I thought that would be fair. Well, other agents said they would do it for less. Oh, I understand you're talking to other agents, and most of them will do it for less. I guess it's important that we discuss commission and what I do to earn it the moment I walk in the door, correct? Well, yes, we better. Now I know that I have to go right to my plan of action, my marketing plan, so I can tell them how I earn the commission. It's a sales process here, folks. The trouble I have is we're dealing too often, present company excluded, with non-salespeople, because we're realtors. Step number four, show up physically, mentally, and emotionally prepared. It's showtime, but be early. Most agents are 10 to 15 to 20 minutes late all the time. I've had agents tell me, I can't believe the seller was offended when I showed up 40 minutes late. I'm a busy person. Now, think about this. Look how mad you get if you go to a doctor or a dentist and they make you wait for your 2 o'clock appointment until 2:45. Think how mad you get if you have a flight from Phoenix to Dallas and you get to the airport an hour and a half in advance and the flight's 45 minutes late. Turn it around for a minute. You don't like it. Why would they like it? And who do you think you are to think that behaving in that manner is a professional manner? See, here's my belief. I always show up 15 minutes early. I sit in front of the house and I read through my listing presentation scripts a couple of times. I review my pre-listing package completely. I am prepared to go in now and make a professional presentation. 4 to 5 minutes in advance, I get out, I straighten my tie, I make sure my hair is combed, I walk up confidently and knock on the door. I am prepared physically, mentally, and emotionally to do the job I have to do. And then step five is follow the listing scripts verbatim. You know, Mike, I've read through your scripts, and quite honestly, I don't like them. I don't remember asking you if you liked them. I don't remember writing them so you'd approve them. I didn't hire you as my editor. Hey, get over yourself. I had a person last week say to me in a seminar, in front of the whole room, you know, Mike, I have to tell you, I don't like you. And I smiled and said, well, we're even. This poor lady didn't know what to say with that one. Do you think I actually care if you like the scripts or not? Watch, I don't think the doctor cares if I like the prescription or the surgery. I'm trying to get better. That's my job. Isn't that your job to get better? But I don't like your scripts. Get over yourself. Non-salespeople don't like the scripts. Salespeople love them. Why? Because it's a question-oriented listing presentation. That's all it is. So let's go back. Five steps. Pre-qualify 100%. Obviously, send out the pre-listing package. Non-ego-oriented. Call back and confirm. Make sure you show up physically, mentally, emotionally on time, and then use the scripts. So let me give you a couple thoughts now to back this up. The first thing I want to say to you, they give the listing to the salesperson who earns it, not to the person who needs it. You earn it by being a professional salesperson. That's a big part of the listing process. Now, I've said this to audiences in the past. Your biggest nightmare in your town, in your city, in your company, I get my license and I'm competing with you because I'm going to beat you like a bad stepchild. You don't have a chance against me. Why? Because I know what to say and I know what to do. And I have the confidence to display that. I can say to a seller, Mr. and Mrs. Seller, I don't need your listing, but you need me to get it sold. And if you want it sold, you're talking to the right guy. They give it to the person that is going to earn it through their skills. And then, of course, as I said last week, first impressions are critical. Everything from the clothes you wear, how well you're groomed, whether your shoes are shined, the smile on your face, the strength of your handshake. Remember I said last week, upgrade, upgrade, upgrade. And then I want to cover one more thought with you on this listing process. Create for yourself a pre-listing routine, a way to get yourself physically, mentally, and emotionally prepared. So I wrote down, get your mindset in order. Okay, if you listen to my CDs, listen to a CD on the way to the house. Get your mindset in order. Get yourself pumped up, motivated, enthused. Practice your presentation. You're in front of the house 15 minutes early. I'm reading through the scripts. I've got a smile on my face. I'm excited. Look and dress professionally. You know when you're out of sync in your appearance. Don't allow that to take place. Ensure that you have all the proper materials with you. You sent them a pre-listing package. Make sure you have a copy. When you walk in the door, you're confident to present the material. And then, of course, always be very punctual. Well, here's what I want you to write down. A, homework, continue practicing your listing presentation. B, actually use it at least once this week. Use it once this week, verbatim. C, start writing out your objections to this so you can talk to your coach, your manager, or send me an email so we can make sure that you're learning it the proper way. I don't think there's any question that you can become a lot better at listing than you are today. And I know that next week when we talk about pricing property, it's going to strengthen your listing presentation. Let's be strong, let's be real good, and let's be a salesperson. Talk to you next week.